Well, howdy, 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 folks. I wanted to come on here because I got a comment that I wanted to share with you, because sometimes you miss the comments, right? But I was going through answering people's comments today.
I wanted to come on here and because I got a...
I about every 2 days, if I can, I go in and try to catch up on comments. And so I apologize if I get back to you late. You can always email me. That's sometimes quicker. I usually only stay about a day behind on emails. The what I wanted to share with you, I'm looking at another screen here trying to pull this up, and hopefully it works. But let's see, do we have, yep, all right. So I want to share this video with you, and then I want to share some tips that he shared with us, all of us. And I think that's pretty cool. Here's the video. Let me see if I can get this to play. It's real short. Okay, I think it's a minute long. Let's see. There she be. I think that's showing. All right, so here you go. Now I want you to look at this setup while it's going, and notice all the little things that Matthew's done here. His cart, his business is called Doggone Good, and look at every little tweak and every little thing he's done to make this inviting and welcoming. It's a lot of work, but it pays off, okay? And so he's at a fixed location. He stays there because it's great. And he's in a little tiny town. It's a one-horse town. It's a little tiny horse, so you won't even see it in the video. But look right here. Let's see the cart there. That's the big dog cart. Got to make a plug there for myself. Now, there's the menu. I'm going to pause that for a second. So let's look at this real quick. Hebrew National. Kosher beef hot dog, $4. A Casper's Chicago-style hot dog, $5. Let's look on down here because we're going to talk about some other stuff. He's got some cool stuff that he does. And look at this, vegan hot dog, a vegan hot dog. And let's see, what does it say? Fire roast or smart dog. He puts the calorie count. $5. A vegan sausage. $7. Boom. Okay. Now I'm gonna give you some more information on this, and it may inspire some ideas in you. Okay. I've got so much stuff to share with you. And hopefully I don't know if I'll get it all done in this video, but I'm gonna get it. I'll do another one maybe tomorrow. Okay. So let's finish this up. We only got a few more seconds here. Notice all the signs. All right, so that's the end of that, and I don't know if you caught, maybe I can get back to this real quick. Did you catch all these mustards? He is in mustard heaven. He's got Grey Poupon, and all I can imagine is somebody pulling up in, you know, some fancy car going, hey, pass me the Grey Poupon, right? That's good branding when that's still stuck in your head after 20 years. I think that was 20 years ago. Might have been 2 days ago. Who knows? I've slept since then. Either way, let me get out of this screen and come back over here. I just love it that Matthew Orth, okay, and he shared this with us, but he shared more, and that's what I wanted to share with you. The guy is amazing. By the way, hi to Alex and Michael and Tammy and Gary. Thank y'all for being here. All right. So let me get on with this. Matthew writes, he goes, "Hey Ben," now this is in one of the video comments. In fact, it's a comment on the tomato video, or Mater, as we say, the Mater video that we just did the other day. So this is a comment on that post. So he says, "Hey Ben, thanks again for all the great advice. I started in February of 2019. With snow still on the ground, and I did great. This is a year-round business for sure. Three topics you may want to touch on. Forgive me if you already have." Okay, now this is what's cool. He's going to share three tips. Music. "I find that playing good music that fits your customer's demographics," and all that means is your area. If you live in Alabama, out in the sticks, you're going to have to play some country music. Maybe a little Lynyrd Skynyrd, but you ain't going to be playing some uppity hair bun music, right? And if you live in Seattle, Washington, you could probably play anything you want because there's so many, it's so diversified, right? That's a big word for a hillbilly. So you have to play to your area. Like if you go to your town, how many radio stations you got? Got four? So what is mostly being played? What's the biggest station? Oh, it's top 40. Well, then by all means, play top 40. So this is great advice. So he says, make it fit your demographic, brings customers in and keeps them coming back. Put together a mixtape of songs with dogs in them. Okay? So now you've got a mixtape that you're playing, so you're controlling your music, okay? So you hook up your little MP3, or now you don't even need an MP3, now it's just on your phone, right? And you're just running through it. He plays stuff like "You Ain't Nothing But a Hound Dog," Atomic Dog, etc. At the end of the day, people won't remember what you said or what you did, but they will remember the way you made them feel. That is fantastic advice. Okay, that is great advice. People like to feel good. That crazy hillbilly boy, he made me feel good. He kicked my tires or whatever. So he pet my dog. And so you don't have to be funny or creative. All you got to do is make them feel good. Well, you can do that by changing the music. If you notice, and I'll put this in your head and this will mess you up, watch any commercial, any TV show, anything. And they have music in the background because music creates emotion. And emotion sucks us in. So you remember things by emotion. You remember stuff by smells and emotion. So I would pay attention to what he's saying here. Okay, now, "Hot dogs are a feel-good food and good music can make their experience so enjoyable." If you see me looking down, I have new bifocals. And they mess with my head to get me dizzy trying to do it. "Good music make their experience so enjoyable on so many levels that it strikes them subconsciously that they must come back again soon." Okay? Now, that was his first tip. That's tip number one. Okay? So, tip number one is to provide music, preferably a playlist. That way you control the music. Now, let me tell you a little about this. We have a member in our Vendors United group. His name's Mark Lawler. You've seen me do some stuff with him, right? And he's got a big Cater Pro. Now he's got a Stand King, and he's getting too big for his britches. And he's an awesome vendor in Alabama, in a little town in Alabama. And now he's got two units out. So Mark plays his own music. But Mark went a step further. Mark injects into the music commercials. Okay, so Mark actually puts commercials into the music. But whose commercials? His commercials. And they're hilarious. He's got a radio voice anyway. If you're in the Vendors United group, you know this, because he does commercials for other vendors too, right, in the group. So he creates them their own little playlist and then adds commercials about a menu item they may have. It's like Corey's Mako Dog. So you're listening to "Ain't Nothing But a Hound Dog," you know, or you're listening to some song, and then all of a sudden comes this commercial break, and it's Mark Lawler with this deep voice that just pulls you in. This right here is the Great American Hot Dog Stand, and we'd like to thank you for visiting today and wanted you to know that we are available for catering gigs and this and that and that and the other. Well, they may not even be paying attention, but it's going into that subconscious. So it is fun as heck. And so we've got a lot of vendors using the playlist that Mark has created. And so he'll take your songs and then whatever songs you want and then inject commercials into it. Don't forget, Thursday is buy one, get one free or whatever it is, right? And so Mark does such a freaking good job at it. So yeah, I'm aware of it and we got vendors doing it. But I think it's cool that Matt would share this with everybody and let people know that, hey, put some freaking music out there. It'll make you feel better and your customer feel better. It's a win-win. Okay? Next, we're going to tip two. Okay? Bear with me. It's late, and look at this. Somebody got this for me. Blowin' Rock, that's from, where is this from? Somewhere in the Carolinas. Yep. Looks like Hickory, North Carolina. So, hickory. That's how they call hickory. They don't say hickory. They say hickory. So, Hickory, North Carolina Blowin' Rock IPA. Deliciousness. So, that's what I'm trying tonight. Anyway, so tip two. Let's do tip two. He says, vegan hot dogs and sausages. Now, I read that to you on his video. The reason I did that is because I had already read this. So it's like I'm a professional. I kind of tied it together. I don't know if you caught that. So here's the deal. Field Roast at Walmart, he says. Field Roast. Walmart has both vegan hot dogs and sausages. Currently, 30% of my hot dog sales are vegan. This is Matt talking, not me, okay? 30% of his sales are vegan. I also offer Amy's organic chili. He gets it off of Amazon for his chili dogs. He pointed that out in the video. I didn't stop it there. I should have. If I was a better broadcaster, I would have. And it was a can of Amy's chili. Here's what he says to say about it. Let's see. Only compliments come from Amy's chili. And not a single meat-eating customer has ever noticed that it's a vegan chili. Only I show off my cans of chili because everyone that knows Amy's products knows the high quality. It is truly the best tasting and highest quality chili in a can, hands down. So everybody put your hands down, right? So I also have vegan cheese. Do you know any hot dog carts that have a vegan chili cheese dog? Yes, I do. Now, he probably knows that I do because he was sharing these tips with you. But, yes, we've got vendors. We had a vendor, I think it was called Fresh For You, and everything they did was vegan. So, they put their hot dogs in a lettuce. I did a video for y'all on that as well. So, and it was a vegan hot dog, and it tasted good. I was impressed. I'm a meat eater, okay? Probably won't change unless the doctor says, hey, you're going to die tomorrow by noon if you don't quit eating meat. And then I might have a little bit more, right? So now, that was tip two. Tip three. Are y'all still with me? All right. So tip three, snow cones, huge markup at $3 each. So he's doing snow cones for $3 each. These have added huge revenue to my cart all summer long. Stick with Hawaiian brand syrups. Big tip there. See, this is stuff you might miss. And you may be calling me up going, Ben, what kind of syrup's best? Because a lot of people use different syrups and some of them are crappy. Like, I'm not going to say the name. But there's several that are mostly just water and corn syrup and red food coloring. So, Hawaiian brand syrups are the best. A nice stainless steel ice shaver is only $130. So, you can get you an ice shaver for $130 delivered on Amazon. It's paid for itself in the first weekend. See my latest setup by clicking the link below. Now, I already showed you the video, right? And you can go to that page. In fact, I need to put that in the... I'll put it... When the video's done, I'll put it in the video description, the link. I should have done that already. Usually I'm on top of that stuff. It's a daggum blowing rock brewery company messing up my thing. All right, so that was your three tips, okay? Now, you don't have to go out tomorrow and go, I got to get a shaved ice or I'm never going to make it. No, you don't have to do any of that. Just start making little steps. Do something different today. Do something different tomorrow. As far as do something that creates a lot of value that doesn't cost you a lot. So what is, Matt didn't start off his setup. I point over here because I still got it on the screen. Matt didn't set up his setup all like that the very first day. He had a nice setup, but it's gotten better. He has just sunflowers growing and everything. The dude has nailed it, okay? In a little bitty town, okay? And maybe he'll share on the comments here where he is and, you know, just don't harass him. So, let me see what we got here. Jay's in house. Joe's in house. Thanks for being here, Cindy. Thanks for being here, Center Alabama, future hot dog vendor right here. Love it. Glad you're here, Cindy. And I'm not even going to try to pronounce your last name. I'll butcher it. You can guarantee I'll butcher it. Let's see. Great idea on the commercials, Jay. I think it is too. We've been doing those. In fact, it was Mark Lawler, Great American Hot Dog Stand in Alabama, that told us about it. He shared it in Vendors United about 3 years ago, and it just went berserk, and a lot of vendors do it now. They have their own little loop, and some of them have a loop of like 50, 60 songs, okay? And then in between every four or five songs, they got a commercial. So, and it's their commercial. It ain't for the old dadgum McDonald's down the street or nothing. It's them. So, just cool. Storm Holmes says, I enjoy your videos. I enjoy, Storm, that you enjoy my videos. I appreciate you being here. I know this is probably not part of the subject, but how do you feel about selling hot dogs from a taco cart? I feel 100% okay with it. I mean, let me just show you how okay I feel about that. Who's saying that? That was Gary, okay? Gary, here is just the most basic setup, and this guy still is set up this way as far as I know, okay? And I want you to look. That's his setup, okay? That's less than a taco cart, right? So does it matter? No, it doesn't matter. Do it your way. It doesn't matter a bit. Just because it's called a taco cart, could it be called a pancake cart? There's some college students in Ohio. They have two of my pro dog carts, which have these big griddles on. And those guys are selling breakfast burritos and pancakes in the morning, and that's their only shift because they're in school during the day. And that's what they're doing, pancakes. So now do I have to rename it the pancake cart? I'm not making fun. I'm just saying it doesn't matter what you're serving on. It doesn't change the name of it just because it's a hot dog cart. It's just because I called it a hot dog cart. It could be your pancake cart. It could be your taco cart. All right. So, and I'm going to be sending out an email. If y'all are on my email list, I'm going to be sending out an email soon with some kick butt stuff that people are doing with breakfast. Some guys just ain't even doing lunch or nothing anymore. They're doing just breakfast. They got coffee urns, and we've had some vendors doing this for years, but it's gotten bigger. And so you may want to jump in on it. If you're an early bird and like getting up early and want to go serve some coffee and some already pre-done burritos and stuff that you made in the commissary or you bought from a supplier, great. Leo Mickey is here. That's been a while. I ain't seen you in a while. Glad you're here. Let's see. I do shave ice for my trailer and I use brand he suggests. It's great. Do y'all remember that brand? The brand tip was, I think, Hawaiian brand. And Tammy's telling you, yes, it's a great brand. So there you go. You got two professional vendors telling you that it's good. Oregon IPA. You know, I have a daughter in Oregon. And I'm going to have to maybe, I don't know if I can get her. I've never seen that brand here. I'll see if I can get it here. If not, I'll have her mail me some, maybe. She's mailed me Stranger Things. I took your advice, watched you for years, and attracted more females than money. that's funny. Lewis says, I took your advice, watched you for years, and attracted more females than money. I've not had that problem. We probably look a lot different is the problem. Look here, Packers Lemonade in the house. There's a man that had a busy, busy weekend. I'm not even going to tell you how busy. I need to share y'all something. You want to get inspired? We have Vendors United, and it's a smaller group of vendors that share secrets and tips. Like every Monday night, we get on and we share all kinds of stuff. And we don't share it anywhere else because you don't want everybody to know. Like Great American Hot Dog Stand shared a big tip last night. Okay, but Ken Packer's in that group as well at Packer's Concessions. And he is, I don't even remember where I was going with this. Oh, I remember now. So he was there last night. Well, no, he wasn't there last night. But Ken is in East Tennessee. He's got hot dogs. He's got lemonade. He's been doing lemonade longer than I've been alive. Not really, but a long, long time. And he is an expert at it. In fact, he has helped tons of vendors and Vendors United do better with their lemonade. And so there's thousands of dollars. In fact, I got two things. I get sidetracked easy. Can you tell, Squirrel? Anyway, so here's the deal. Two things. I had a lady call me. This has been maybe two, three weeks ago. It wasn't that long ago. It was in August. And she says, I think it's too late to get in lemonade. Season's almost over. And then, you know, and I said, yeah, you're nearing the end of the season. You can do lemonades all year long. We've got vendors that do it in the South, but it's a little more expensive to get them, but your profit, you just raise your price and you cover you're still making the same money. But I get it. You may be in Ohio and lemonade doesn't do real good in January, right? So, but anyway, she was going, it's too late. I missed the boat. I wish I'd have found you sooner. And I told her, I said, listen, let me just, I said, I want you to close your eyes. I was on the phone with her, so I couldn't see if she was doing what I asked, but I asked her to. I said, close your eyes. And I said, now imagine this. I said, this weekend, you're going to go to the flea market. And you're going to have a pretty good time. You don't have a ton of money, but you're going to have a pretty good time, and you're going to sell lemonades. And with your little, I'm talking cheap setup. I've got a whole video on how to set it up cheap, $300, right, or less. So set it all up, right? And in that weekend, you're going to make $1,500. No, I don't want you to get excited yet. Now, the next week, you're going to be loaded for bear. You're going to go with more lemons because you got profit now, right? You made some money. Now you can buy some more lemons, maybe an extra smasher, and maybe pay that lady, a single mom from church who needs some extra money, $100 to help you that day, right? So now you've got you and this other lady. You got two smashers going, and you're kicking butt, and you do $7,200, right? And you go, well, dang, this ain't bad. I said, now I want you to imagine your bank account with that extra $9,000 in it now. Or let's just say it's $5,000. I said, is it too late to get $5,000? Like, have you ever had somebody try to give you money and you go, I don't, no, it's too late. You know, if you'd have come to me yesterday with that $5,000, I'd have took it. But today it's already middle of the week. I don't need that. No, nobody does that. That's ridiculous. But when you think about it in terms of this, this may propel you to another business. So you start with lemonade right now. Let's say you only get two more weekends in. Oh, crap. I only made a few $1,000. That sucks. And then you take that money and maybe get your kettle corn machine going, right? Or you get your funnel cake machine, or your mini donut machine, or your hot dog cart, because a hot dog cart you can use year round. Doesn't matter how cold it is. People love freaking hot dogs. So there's why it's not too late. Too late is when you never do it. So just remember that. Anyway, that was one thing I wanted to mention. The second thing is during the meeting last night, this is how quick I get sidetracked, Vendors United, we were talking, and listen, The weekend had just happened. I don't know if y'all noticed. We just had a weekend. And it's I get emails and stuff from vendors in the group. a lot of them. And so I just started noticing all these. I was getting a lot of emails. And 31 I got. There was a couple that I got I didn't count, okay, because I'm not 100% sure. As far as the numbers, I just don't know, okay? But 31 of them that I know, trust, and know, sent me emails or a message through WhatsApp and said, Ben, look what we did this weekend. Now, this is Labor Day weekend, right? So, this is what I got. 31 emails, 31 vendors, did a total of $116,441.50. That's what those vendors did this weekend. That's 31 vendors. Now, I don't know what that breaks down to if you averaged it. 31 into 116, it's got to be somewhere over $3,000, right? Because $3,000 would be about 99,000. So, yeah. So, it's over it's roughly $3,500 each that they averaged each. Not bad, right? I don't know about you. I've worked a lot of other jobs. I've never made $3,500 in a freaking week, especially a weekend. So I just love it, and I wanted to share that with you. All right, thanks for Ken inspired that. I thought of that. I've been a DJ for 10 years. It will be commercials going ASAP. Glad I get to see your videos. Thanks. Look at that. Jay, that's what Mark was. He was a DJ. He's already got that radio voice, you know, that sexy radio voice, and it just, his southern accent in Alabama, of course, you wouldn't want a different type of accent in Alabama, and because they still hang, and, you know, the lynch mob and Burns, and they're crazy in Alabama. They just got running water inside, so I'm just kidding. I love Alabama. I've got family in Alabama. All right, so now let's go. Thanks for the encouragement. Should be up and running pretty soon. Getting all my supplies ready. That's Gary. Congratulations, Gary. I look forward to getting updates. Email me updates. Tell me about it. Look at there, Tom. That Tom knows. See, cook anything on a hot dog cart. Yeah, just because I call it a hot dog cart, it's a mini mobile kitchen. There, mini mobile kitchen. We ought to rename it. Mini mobile kitchen. So you've got a steam table. That steam table cooks, boils, and steams. So you've got what a restaurant has. And if you add a griddle or a grill or a smoker, whatever you do, you know, you got everything they got. This is Obi. Hi, Ben. It's Obi from Simba's Hot Dogs in Hartford, Connecticut. Awesome. Thanks for being here. Glad you're here with us. Secured a spot by the airport. Fat Tony's is ready. Tony, congratulations. That's awesome. Winter comes early to upstate New York. Just wondering, is hot lemonade a thing? I know that hot apple cider is a thing in my area. Okay, I don't know about hot lemonade, but I would imagine, you know, spiced up right, hot lemonade could be like pretty cool. It'd be like a comfort food to me. So yeah, it may be a thing. That's a good question, John. Your earlier videos made me insane amount of money. Thanks. Well, thank you, Lewis. I appreciate you saying so. We had a lot. My videos didn't do it though, Lewis. You know that, right? I did some videos. You took the information and did it. So that's the cool part, is you're 100% responsible for that success. Just because, I mean, do you think that I was born the hot dog guru? No. I learn stuff every day. Every day. I learned something new last night on Vendors United. No joke. From Mark Lawler. And just, we have a lot of fun in there. If you're serious about business, jump in Vendors United. Castro Dogs in the house. How you doing, brother? Love you. Doing my due diligence, learning a lot. Can't wait to get started. There's a great one right there. Doing his due diligence. Because due diligence is important, and I'm glad he's doing it. That is just doing what you think you need to, doing the stuff you need to do. Taking the right steps. You don't just go out and buy a cart because you got excited and go, okay, now I'm ready. And then find out, oh, I got to have a food safe manager permit, or I got to get a license. Where do you get these hot dogs? You know, all that stuff. You want to do your due diligence, so when you're ready, you're ready. There's no hidden surprises. Deerslayer in the house. Michael White, watch your videos for more than 2 years. They have helped me a lot. Thank you. Hurricane Alley, Daytona. Man, I've got two daughters in Florida, and I know they ain't gonna leave. And then I've got one on the coast of North Carolina, and she probably won't leave. Although last year, they're still recovering from last year's hurricane that got the Wilmington, Jacksonville, North Carolina area. And they ain't even over that big mess. But she did come because they lost power for weeks. So she came the last time, but she waited till the last minute. But I hope you're safe, and I hope you take care and batten down the hatches or leave. Ola Ben sent you an email. I have some issues here in North Carolina. I don't know when you sent the email, but if it was today, I may not have made it to it. If it was any time before today, I've done those. I was current as of about noon today with yesterday's emails. Ben had to get a new HVAC system. Has set me back. Absolutely, Sandra. A new HVAC system would set me back. Don't worry. There's always stuff. Everybody has stuff. Everybody has things. But guess what? You'll recover from this setback, and then you'll move on. What the cool thing is you'll never, once you get going, you'll never again have to rely on somebody else, because you'll be able to find ways to make money with this that are incredible. And if you follow the leaders, as far as follow all the vendors out there that are doing it, you'll go, oh, this ain't that bad. And now I got $3,000 in the bank. And a month from now, you got $7,000 in the bank. And this is after you've paid your bills. And pretty soon, you've got a little reserve and you can breathe a little bit. You're like, man, if I didn't work for the next 2 months, I could pay my bills. You're talking about a good feeling. That's freedom. That's true freedom. Or when you're, like, I have a daughter right now called me up. She lives in Nashville, Tennessee. Went going through a breakup and everything, and she called me up. Dad, I want to come just hang out for a couple days. And I'm like, sure, come on. Because you can do that. You can stop. You don't have to call the boss and go, hey, I got a daughter who needs some help. I need comfort or need to hang out with. Probably won't be at work. No, you ain't got to call nobody. I love the freedom of this. Let's see. Oh, there's a good question. Is it Slanya? I hope that's right. Slanya. Ola Ben, I don't have a lemonade smasher. What equipment can I start with to do shakers? You don't need a smasher. I've got videos on here how to do it without a smasher. You've heard of a muddler? You know what that is? Like a citrus press. You just press it. It's like a dome-shaped citrus press, and you just press it in. We got a lady. I interviewed her live on here. Live on here. A single mom started with a muddler, okay? And just build it from there. You can definitely use a muddler. I've got the whole list. If you go to learnhotdogs.com/lemon or howtostartalemonadebusiness.com, I've got everything there for you. Just mind-blowing amount of information that will get you going without spending a bunch of money. Joseph's about to complete his commissary. Awesome. Okay, here's Ken Packer says, VU is awesome. He's talking about Vendors United. Had the chance to sit beside a newbie in a local event this weekend. Spent time helping him. See, and I got to know about that because this other guy's brand new and gets to work with the Ken. I mean, Kenzel helps a ton of vendors because he knows his stuff. And he never scrimps. He never shortchanges his customer, never shortchanges his setup. He's always got it down right. And he does it right, and that's why he's successful. And you can too. So, let's see. I would like to send you what you inspired me to build was an tent, build a whole trailer. Just started with hot dogs, been doing popcorn and shaved ice. Slick Earl, that is freaking awesome. Yes, yeah, I'd love it. Send me an email with some pictures and stuff, okay? Ben at VendorsUnited.com. Just send it there. Or Ben at LearnHotDogs.com. Both of them will get to me. I'd love to see it, Slick Earl. Hot lemonade and apple cider has cold flu prevents quantities and qualities and sells great during the fall and winter. There's Sandra. So Sandra says, yes, hot lemonade. That's a thing. So it sounds good. I don't think I've ever had it, but Daniel's going to DIY a cart and then buy a new one. You may not need a new one. You may be tickle pink with your one you built. So you may not need to do nothing except just build you a cart. Go to work. If I were up north, I would sure try hot lemonade for sure. I may try it down here when it's cold out. Yeah, it doesn't get cold out much. Black Hoodie Fitness. I just booked my first catering gig, Ben, because of you. That is, congratulations, Black Hoodie Fitness. Catering is taking over this business, and not like you think, okay? But if you just want to know more, I'm not going to go into a rant on that. I've already taken a lot of your time. LearnHotDogs.com and just click on the search tab and type in catering. And you will pull up so much stuff the way us vendors are catering and getting private gigs. And it's huge, and you'll make a ton of money. A ton of money doing it. It's phenomenal. Okay. Can I freeze my Nathan's hot dogs? On the package, it says keep refrigerated. What can I freeze them to take to my location? Okay, well, here's the deal. You're not going to hurt them, probably, to try it. So try a few. See if it changes anything. I've used Nathan's, okay? And I had no problems freezing my Nathan's, but I was buying them and they were frozen. So I don't know why yours are saying keep refrigerated unless it's some new type of Nathan's. And maybe it is. Maybe they got a new thing out and they don't want them froze. Not that I know of, and there's a lot of vendors use Nathan. So I just try it. What does it hurt? Try it at your house. Stick it in the freezer in the morning. Get up for breakfast. Guess what you're having? A Nathan's hot dog. Thaw it out. Boil it. Try it. See what it tastes like. Ben, please make sure you stress the importance of signage. You don't have any. Don't even set up. Amen, Broccoli Heart. Yeah, signage is crucial. I get emails from vendors and they go, Ben, I just don't know what to do. I ain't making no money. And ultimately, it always comes up to their setup. It always does. If you've watched any of my cart critiques, you'll see it's always the setup. Okay. And so Broccoli Heart's right. People will go, man, I can't afford signs right now. Yes, you can. Get you some cardboard from the furniture store that they're about to crush and write on it. There's your signs. And then tomorrow, now you can afford to order you some banners. Okay? You can keep getting better and bigger signs, but the point is, you got to have something. But 99 times out of 97 times, do the math on that. So, pretty much 100% of the time, it comes down to vendor setup, and usually that is a problem with their signs. They ain't got none. So, they just expect people to look over there and go, oh, that must be a hot dog cart. I think I'll go have me some lunch. Nope. You got to tell people with signs. So, Sandra, thank you very much. And Double T's here. Lazarus is fixing to start. Congratulations. Look here. I want you to see this. Black Hoodie Fitness says, yes. Now, he's the one I just posted up that just got his first catering gig. Yes, I made more money in 6 hours than I do at my full-time job in a month. I am not kidding, y'all. It's not like, I mean, I could see if I was like some kind of snake oil salesman, right? And I could go, all right, so you can make a lot of money, but in a week, everybody figure you out. No, you can't. You can't sell ice to Eskimos, right? You really can't. Like, they don't buy ice because they can go outside and get ice, right? So, for the most part, I'm assuming. Never been to Alaska, but I assume that. Makes sense. So, if you are... We've been doing this a long time. I've been on the YouTubes for 10 years at least now. And we've got vendors like Michael Wood just celebrated Monday his 10th year, okay, and with his big dog cart. He's part-time, and he makes a full-time income, okay? A full-time income, part-time. And now he's getting these gigs. Y'all saw one of the gigs I did with him this year. Me and Mark Lawler went and helped him because it was a big gig at Husqvarna. So those are things you can do, but this is a guarantee. If you do these things, and that's why I provide the free training at learnhotdogs.com. You can do lemonade there. I've got it all there for you, from donuts to boiled peanuts. If you do these things, you will make good money. You will make a living. Could you run into some obstacles? Yes. We all have. We just move over them. I don't care if you're going to open up a seed business or a hay baling company or an insulation company. Whatever, you're going to have little obstacles. You'll get over it. The difference is this business won't own you. You'll own it. And you'll have more freedom than you've ever had. You'll love it. I promise. It's fantastic. And it works for everybody. The only people that leave it are just the ones that hate it or that aren't self-motivated. Entrepreneurship is not for the guy who needs to be told, Bubba, I need you in over here at 8 a.m., okay? And you can go to the bathroom at 10:15. You got a 10-minute break. And then at noon, we're going to let you eat lunch, okay? But you need to be back on your machine at 12:45. Some people like that rigid schedule. I've got some kids that prefer that, the rigid schedule. They find safety and comfort in knowing, I'm going to have a check this week of $412.92. I know I'm going to have it every Friday as long as I keep going to this job. And then I've got the kids that go, yeah, 412 ain't going to cut it. I need to be doing 412 a day, and I'd like to do that in the noon part of the day and not work all day long because I got fishing and stuff. There's that kind of stuff. So there's all those things we all have to consider, so it's not for everybody, but you can do it. Anyone can do it. It's digging holes, you know? It's digging holes. You know what, Reagan? You said you need to set yourself apart from 7-Eleven or QT markets. No, you're already apart. If you have a cart, you're already apart. Nobody goes, boy, your dogs taste an awful lot like 7-Elevens. Nobody does that. If you're driving down the road and you see a nice setup with a cart and you see a 7-Eleven with some roller dog grills, you know, which one are you going to get? And I've had 7-Eleven hot dogs, okay? They're okay. I ain't going to go out of my way to get one, but if I'm already there getting gas and Rolaids, I might have one and an extra pack of Rolaids. But then, if I have a choice, I'm going to stop at the freaking hot dog vendor. You are too. I don't care if I got to pay $2 more to eat better. I'm still going to eat a hot dog for $3 or $4, and it's going to be freaking delicious. I'm not going to have to wonder what's in it. So don't worry about setting yourself apart. Just be you. Be you. That you're not in competition with a convenience store at all. Don't even think about it. I have vendors call me, Ben, 7-Eleven's got a 3 for $1 on hot dogs today if you got your 7-Eleven card. Who cares? So, you want cheap hot dogs. I mean, you can get some cheap hot dogs. You can get them cheaper than that. Ain't no sense in that. Don't ever put yourself up with them. It's not the same thing at all. All right, that's it. I've went on too long. I appreciate you. I love you. I hope you have a great evening. I know it's late, but I wanted to do this. I want to thank again Doggone Good Hot Dogs for allowing me to share this and sharing his 3 tips. If you missed them, they're at the beginning of this long diatribe I just went on. I hope y'all have a wonderful evening, and I'll see you tomorrow because I got some other stuff coming your way.